You can just look at me when we're talking.
Pardon?
You can just look right at me.
Okay, fine.
Tell me a little bit about this play, Trying.
Well, Trying is a play that's autobiographical. It's written by the woman that lived it. To my knowledge, and this is everything in it, is what she says happened. And I don't know of any other play quite like that. And there's a performance by a young actress that is absolutely brilliant, who plays her. It's a two-character play. I play an older man, a historically true, valid guy named Francis Biddle, who was the Attorney General during the imprisonment, or internment, they called it, of the American citizens of Japanese descent. Not a nice chapter in our history. And he was the Attorney General under FDR, and he was against it. Now, the Attorney General should have the prevailing voice in what's legal and what isn't, you know, what's constitutional, but he was not able to prevail. The Secretary of War was. He prevailed. So they took American citizens and put them in the internment camps. And this young girl came, he was now the man that opposed it, Francis Biddle. He now in the play is an old man and very embittered about what he had to do, or he tried, but he failed.
Right.
And at that time, everybody was kind of frightened, particularly in California. And in fact, I was at the time a law student at Yale and studying the Constitution, and said to myself, this doesn't sound right to me. I was a kid. Eleanor Roosevelt was the only voice, really, that I'm aware of raised other than the American Civil Liberties Union. They said, you can't do it. That's unconstitutional. You can't do that. We got some stuff going on right now that would seem to mirror the same kind of thing. And this young girl went to apply for a job of secretary. She came from Canada, in the middle of the Thule's out there, Saskatchewan.
Right.
And she comes to try to become his secretary to this man who's really a very difficult fellow to get along with, because he's very bright, but he's losing his bright. He's losing not his mind, but it's wandering on him, and he can't remember as he wishes he could, and so there's a great anger, as there is in many older people, when they start to die, you know. He knows he's about to go, and he did. He said he had a year left, and he was right, he died. So that's the play about her coming and in combat, if you will, with this guy. She doesn't leave because he's really very cruel to her, but she sticks it out. She got a lot of guts.
Kind of like the change of the passing of the torch, if you will, from old to young.
Well, of course, this is from 80 to 25,
right.
And that's a big reach.
Yeah.
You know, you're not going to win any relay races with that reach, with the baton, you know.
What drew you to this role?
Well, Ford's Theater, I played there a lot, and I've enjoyed every single minute of it because it represents to me the dark side of our country, that terrible assassination of Lincoln, and the sunlight side, where we come back. Because, as you know, the theater was closed, and storage, that was always used for, nobody wanted to look at it. You know, we're not too fond of looking at Dealey Plaza either, you know, where Kennedy was assassinated. But anyway, then a lady came along named Frankie Hewitt, and she said, no, Abraham Lincoln loved the theater, and even though it was the place of his demise, we should bring it back with energy, and so she did. And it's, as I say, it represents those two elements in our country's makeup. We can be defeated for a moment. We come back. We have always come back.
We have, I think, with September 11th, we've shown the strongest resilience, I think, of any.
Well, it's not over.
Yeah.
Well, we're still in the middle of it. And whether it was a right step or a wrong step is yet to be determined.
Mm-hmm.
You know, whether you can invade a sovereign country, regardless of how miserable you feel they are, is a question. International law has always said that you can't.
Right.
United Nations Charter said, that's a no-no, don't do that. We did. So we'll see.
So you come here and doing theater, and you've done you know your career. I've got your list of everything here, and it's probably about 10 pages long. Your career has spanned so many. You've done theater, and you've done TV, you've done movies. What's your favorite? What's the
theater? Sure, theater, because it's human beings relating to one another. The audience is there, sending out their rays, and we're on the stage sending out our rays, and it's the old town meeting, that phenomenon of human beings getting together and sometimes solving things. Very often not, just winding up yelling at each other and throwing things. But theater I love, and of course it's an actor's medium, mm-hmm. because once the curtain goes up, the lights go on, it's your baby, you know, and all that can happen then is turn the lights out. But it's our time.
What kind of new projects are you working on?
Well, my son, my oldest boy, Jim, is a wonderful director and film, and also an actor. And last summer we did Inherit the Wind together.
Right.
And this next summer we're going to do Tuesdays with Boring.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah, together.
A lot of people know you from your role as Brooks Hatlin from Shawshank Redemption.
Yes.
What was it like working on that movie?
It was a good experience.
Yeah.
Because of the man that wrote it and directed it, Frank Darabont, and the other actors were wonderful. Good script, good director, and good actors, and you're apt to have a good one. And that did become a good film, I think.
Now let me take what you said there about good acting to the stage, because you guys you're interacting with each other, and it takes the good actors. It's kind of like a relationship with a husband and wife. It's good chemistry with the people. You find that to be the case?
Well, sure. I think it's true in life. You know, if you marry the right woman, you got the good right chemistry, that helps with the family and with in a country too. The strange way, there is a chemistry of a country. That if you defy it, if you ruin it, it may make things harder to get things done, to have good governance.
Wonderful.